Hello, hello, hello. Good afternoon, Giants fans! Wow, you all are amazing coming out in this weather today. Give yourselves a round of applause. Are you ready to continue this celebration? I need you fired up right now. The guys are waiting to come on out. So when I say go, you say Giants, okay? Go! 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 That's what I'm talking about. Three-time world champion San Francisco Giants! You know, in 2012, I stepped up to the podium and I said to you all, it was so nice, they did it twice. Well, it's so gosh darn nice, we've done it thrice, okay? I don't even know if that's a word, but I'm gonna use it, thrice. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it is my absolute honor to officially welcome you for the third time in 5 years to the official city celebration honoring your 2014 World Champion, San Francisco Giants! And by the way, fans, you too are world champions, right? Stronger together, all together, together we are giants! And this never gets old, right? Who cares about the rain? This feels good, right? We can keep doing this every other year, don't you think? Take a year off and rest, come back and do it again in 2016. Well, today we are joined by a number of very special dignitaries who have helped to make San Francisco the best baseball town in America. And this works out so well because all of you are the best baseball fans in all of America. And dare I say, all of the world! A little bit louder! And now please join me in welcoming today's very special dignitaries and guests. First of all, representing the Honorable Dianne Feinstein, her husband, Richard Blum. The Honorable Nancy Pelosi and her husband, Paul Pelosi. The Honorable Gavin Newsom and wife, Jennifer Siebel Newsom. The Mayor of the City and County of San Francisco, the Honorable Edwin Lee. Former Mayor, all done up in his orange today as only he can do, the Mayor, Willie Brown. Also with us today, Kathleen Sullivan Alioto. The Chief of Protocol for the City and State, Charlotte Schultz, and the Honorable George Schultz. And now from the Giants, members of the Giants Ownership Board, starting with President and CEO Larry Bear and his wife Pam. Jenny Johnson and Suzanne Scovern. Greg Johnson and Lindsay Johnson. Alan and Miriam Beyer. And Philip Beyer. Rob and Trina Dean. Steve and Tori Humphrey. David Jenkins and Lisa Spear. Gary and Terry Iskowitz. And of course, Giants Senior Vice President and General Manager, Brian Sabian and his wife, Amanda. And the skipper's wife, Kim Bochy. Former Managing General Partner, Peter McGowan and his wife, Debbie McGowan. And former Managing General Partner, Bill Newcomb and his wife, Sally. Let's hear it for former Giants owner Bob Lurie and his wife Connie. And representing the Stoneham family, Jamie Rupert and Kim Rupert. And now on to our distinguished Giants alumni, the inspirational Dave Dravecki. the hack man, Jeffrey Leonard. Former first baseman, J.T. Snow. And now a man who is often mistaken to be my husband, it's Mike Tiny Felder. Fred Brining, everyone. Rich Robertson. How about it for Terry Whitfield? Brian Johnson, everyone. And the man that needs no introduction, I simply say to you, the home run king, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Barry Bonds. You can show him your love, of course. Do it. Do it. And now on to our Giants Hall of Famers, starting with Mr. Gaylord Perry. The Baby Bull, Orlando Cepeda. The Dominican Dandy, Juan Marichal. Our beloved stretch, number 44, Willie McCovey. And last but certainly not least, the best player to ever play this game, the Say Hey Kid, the great Willie Mays. All right, and now everyone, we've got to take a moment to thank the City and County of San Francisco and our community partners, Bank of America, AAA, Dignity Health, Miller Coors, Virgin America, PG&E, and Levi's. They have all helped to make this huge civic celebration possible. So please give it up for our community partners. They're making it all happen for us today. We also want to recognize the Giants broadcast partner, Comcast SportsNet Bay Area, which brings Giants baseball to all of our fans all season long. And they've made it possible for today's event to be viewed by Giants fans all over Northern California. And of course, a big shout out to our listeners and fans tuned in to the Giants flagship radio station on KBR 680, the sports leader. Thanks for watching and thanks for listening, everybody. And now I do believe we have a very special greeting from a San Francisco favorite. Let's take a look, everybody.
San Francisco Giants, you've done it before, and you've done it again, and you're going to do it again and again, because the San Francisco public loves you, and I love you so much. Congratulations, and have a great day.
The great Tony Bennett! Awesome! And now, everyone, it is my pleasure to introduce to you a member of the best broadcast team in all of baseball. Please welcome our very own Hall of Famer, Mr. John Miller!
Thank you, Ronelle. And first off, we are all awed by you. It wasn't a great day out here, but here you are. And once again, I join with Ronelle saying, let's hear it for you, great Giants fan. Yeah. And I know this sounds odd because we have a parade. It hasn't rained here for what? The last 3 years. So let's hear it for the rain. And that is an all-time Major League record, the first time the rain ever got cheered. Well, let's meet these 2014 Giants. First off, the legend who just completed his 57th season with the Giants. He's the clubhouse manager, Mike Murphy. Now, the Giants had a lot of injuries and things to contend with this year. The training staff was key to their success. Let's meet head trainer Dave Greshner, assistant trainers Anthony Reyes, assistant trainer Eric Ortega, strength and conditioning coach Carl Cochin, and Ogawa-san, Haro Ogawa. All right, now the coaches of the Giants. Third base coach, Tim Flannery. Bullpen coach, Mark Gardner. Catching instructor, Bill Hayes. First base coach, Roberto Kelly. Assistant hitting instructor, Joe LaFay. And the hitting instructor, Hensley Bam Bam Mullins. The pitching coach for the Giants, Dave Righetti. And the Giants bench coach, Ron Wotus. Also, Giant coaches Jose Aguasil, Chad Chop, Sean Dunston, who is the video guy in the clubhouse, and got the first overturn call in World Series history, Sean Dunston. And from the bullpen, Taira Uematsu. Now, there, before this year, were nine managers who led their teams to at least three World Series titles, and they're all in the Baseball Hall of Fame in Cooperstown. Now, another with his third World Series championship, so he, I'm guessing, will be the 10th to join those other great managers at the Hall of Fame. He's our own, the manager of the World Champion Giants, Bruce Bochy. That's three. I'm counting them right now. Let's hear it. Three, 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 three. Yeah. Three. Wow. In 5 years. All right, now let's meet the players. And he played a big role in the Giants' success. In the last five games, there were no home runs, except he hit one that was 4 inches from going out. In game five, outfielder Juan Perez, number two. There are a lot of Giants rookies on this team, including a young infielder who made his first opening day roster, number six, Ere Adrianza. This guy started in center field. They were missing Angel Pagan, the regular center fielder, and they won the World Series again with him out there every day. Left field in 2012, center field this year, number seven, Gregor Blanco. There are a lot of World Series where this next guy would have been the World Series MVP, but he got overshadowed a little bit. There was another guy who was even better, but it was an incredible World Series, an incredible postseason, and an incredible run for the Giants' Iron Man. Right fielder, number eight, Hunter Pence. hit 444 in the World Series. Back in the Division Series, when it was still very much in doubt who was going to win, it was the 18th inning, tied for the longest game in postseason history, and he got the winning run with a home run in the 18th. First baseman number 9, Brandon Belt. The Giants had a hole at second base, and they tried to fill it with this guy, that guy, this guy, and finally, up from the minor leagues, he came, and they could not, literally could not, have won it without him. He hit over 300 in his rookie season, and he may have started the greatest double play ever seen in a World Series game. Number 12, Joe Panik. A guy who could play anywhere on the field, and he got a key pinch hit in the Giants' come-from-behind victory in Game 4. Number 13, Joaquin Arias. A veteran catcher who appeared in the regular season for the Giants with experience and depth being offered at the catching position. Number 14, Guillermo Quiroz. He's always been one of the best pitchers in the game, 16 years in the big leagues, but he had never pitched in a World Series. Now he's pitched in a World Series. He's pitched in a Game 7 of a World Series. Number 17, Tim Hudson. I still can't believe that the Giants won the World Series without this guy being a huge part of it, because that just would not seem possible. But he's going to be back next year stronger than ever, and we don't ever want to try and win another one without him. Ladies and gentlemen, number 18, Matt Cain. We picked this guy up in a trade. He won a World Series ring last year. Now he's won one 2 years in a row. And the Giants would not have gotten there without him. Clearly, they needed somebody to pick up in Matt Cain's shoes, and he did a fabulous job. A 2.17 ERA for the Giants. Number 22, Jake Peavy. This next gentleman is the first player to win the Rookie of the Year Award, a National League MVP, and to play for the winning team in three different World Series, all before he turned 28. Number 28, Buster Posey. This next pitcher has never started a postseason game that the Giants lost. The Giants are 7-0 when he has started. Number 32, Ryan Vogelsong. another outstanding Giant rookie who came up and played a key role. He was a catcher. He became one of their best pinch hitters. He can hit, he can throw, he can do it all. Number 34, Andrew Susak. Before the Giants had that winner-take-all Game 7 of the World Series, they started the postseason with a winner-take-all one-game playoff in Pittsburgh, and this guy got it all started in a very big way with a grand slam, and he had a great postseason after that as well. Ladies and gentlemen, Giants shortstop number 35, Brandon Crawford. Another Giants rookie came up to the ball club several times from Fresno. He hit a couple of big home runs for the Giants. Number 37, Adam Duvall. And part of the saga of the Giants, they had key guys injured, including their left fielder, and he didn't play for 2 months, and all of a sudden, in the clinching game of the League Championship Series. As a pinch hitter, he hit an eighth inning homer to tie the game. And then in the clinching game of the World Series, he got the base hit that drove in what proved to be the winning run. Left fielder number 38, Michael Morse. And if you want to win in the postseason, you need a guy like this helping to anchor your bullpen. He has gone 22 consecutive postseason games without allowing a run. Number 41, the winning pitcher in Game 7, Jeremy Affeldt. He won a World Series ring with the Giants back in 2010, and then was with several other teams. The Giants brought him back this year as a first baseman, as a pinch hitter. And finally, for the postseason, I said, you think he can play left field? Well, he did. Day after day, he hit the game-winning home run to win the pennant for the Giants, the second Giant ever to do it. Number 45, Travis Ishikawa. Another anchor in the bullpen for all three of these postseason runs. This year, 7 1/3 scoreless innings. The Giants closer, number 46, Santiago Casilla. This next gentleman is a finalist this year in the Gold Glove balloting. He also had a record number of hits, 26 hits in the postseason. Nobody's ever had that many before. Ladies and gentlemen, number 48, el primer jugador de tercera base en todo el mundo, Pablo Sandoval. There's one Giant who's won 3 World Series rings as a Giant, and he's won 4 altogether. Giants left-hander, number 49, Javier Lopez. This Giant rookie scored from second base on a wild pitch to tie the game in the ninth inning in St. Louis. And then he got a key pinch hit to help spur the comeback in game four of the World Series. Number 50, Matt Duffy. This guy came up in the minor leagues, another Giants rookie. His first major league pitch, 101 miles per hour. We'll be seeing a lot more of him, I'm sure, in the future. Number 51, Eric Cordier. And this guy, six shutout innings in the 18-inning game, and two other times, three shutout innings coming into the middle innings, 12 innings with no runs allowed and three wins out of the bullpen. Number 52, Yusmero Petit. Another three-time World Series champion as a Giant. This year, nine postseason games, only one run allowed. Number 54, Sergio Romo. Two-time Cy Young Award winner. He pitched 1 2/3 innings in the World Series, and then his back tightened up on him. Number 55, Tim Lincecum. A prospect out of the Giants farm system. And he made the wild card game roster for the postseason, the division series roster as well. He's fast. He's a real fast guy. Center fielder number 56, Gary Brown. A guy who was in 61 regular season games for the Giants out of the bullpen and did a great job out there. Number 57, Juan Gutierrez. And one of the stories about this postseason, a guy brought up from double-A ball to have a look-see in September, ended up being on the staff, and he got the save in the 18th inning game in Washington. Number 60, Hunter Strickland. Year-old right-hander out of the bullpen, led the team in appearances in the regular season, 71 games. Number 63, Gene Machi. Also up several times with the Giants this year, won a World Series ring 2 years ago, again this year. Number 70, reliever George Contos. We were blessed here in San Francisco. The Giants not only won the World Series, but we watched one of the greatest performances in the history of the game. Nobody is any better in his World Series career. You can look it up. He's at the top of the list. Number 40, Madison Bumgarner. gentlemen, the world champion, San Francisco Giants. Now, ladies and gentlemen, here to make a very special presentation, please welcome the Honorable Mayor of the great city and county of San Francisco, Edwin Lee.
Yes! Yes! Yes, we did it! Folks, we're here today to celebrate our San Francisco Giants. And we all feel a little taller today. Our Giants more than shocked the world this last Wednesday with a dramatic Game 7 win, and they secured a place forever in our hearts, in our history books. My friends, over the past 5 years, we've been fortunate enough to celebrate 3 world championships. In 2010, with Timmy and Matty, Buster and Bochy. And then in 2012, with Matty and Pablo, Buster and Bochy. And in 2014, I have to say, this one provided the most excitement, the most torture, and a story that will grow to be legendary. I mean, come on! We had Marcy Nishikawa's late inning heroics! We had hit after hit from Panda! Hit after hit after hit, Pablo! You own the postseason! And we had an incredible defense from Panic and Crawford. And of course, Giants fans, we had the miracle of Madison Bumgarner. The unhittable ace that led us to victory after victory and then came out of the bullpen to finish off the mighty Royals in Game 7. Mad Bum was so good that Bochy didn't even think about bringing Casilla in, who was also incredible. Madison, what can you say? You rewrote history, you turned baseball upside down, and you broke every record. So I have a few questions today to ask. Is Mad Bum a man or a machine? Second question, when is Bochy going to be eligible for the Hall of Fame? Final question, as mayor, is there anything I can do to keep Panda in San Francisco? Seriously, what a series. This team has already become legendary. Whether it's a grizzled veteran or a fresh-faced rookie, everyone contributed. Everyone stepped up. And everyone came together to will this team to victory. It's a great story. It's a team like this, a team that succeeds not because of any single superstar, but because of dedication. Dedication to each other and to a larger purpose. It's a team like this that's really, really San Francisco. And it's a reason why San Franciscans and Giants fans everywhere adore this team. Time and time again, you keep showing us how 25 people can band together to achieve something greater than any one person. You never give up. You never stop fighting. You find wins, ways to win together as a team. That's who you are. That's who we are. You, San Francisco Giants, inspire all of us. This city loves you. You see it in the skyline, awash in orange. You see it on the faces of every fan and kid. You thrill us. You torture us, and you make us the proudest city in the world, because together we are Giants. And today, once again, we are champions. So congratulations to Larry Bear, to Brian, to Bruce, Madison, Buster, Panda, Pence, Blanco, Perez, Petit, all of you, thank you once again, defying the odds and bringing our city another World Series title. And in recognition of this baseball dynasty, I'm proud to present the highest honor we have in the city to the entire team, the players, to the coaches, to the people who work in the front office, the back office, and all the concession stands. Charlotte, we have here with us, if I can ask, Larry Bear and Bruce Bochy to please come on up on behalf of a very grateful city and a very, very happy and grateful mayor. It is my honor to present to you the key to the city of San Francisco. Across the city, it is today my pleasure to declare this to be San Francisco Giants Day.
The celebration continues. How y'all doing out here? In the back, let me hear you! Yeah, we see you, we see you. And now it is my absolute privilege and honor to bring to the podium right now your Giants president and CEO, Larry Bear. Larry?
Welcome, Giants fans. How you doing? Now, for those of you who are here from out of town, just want to let you know we have this little gathering. This little gathering is something we do on Halloween in San Francisco every 2 years. But I would suggest, why don't we change it up? Maybe we go out of order and book this plaza right now for October 2015. What do you think? The Giants are the first National League team since the 1940s to win 3 World Series championships in 5 years. Since the 1940s. It's amazing, it is the stuff of dreams, and yet it is not a surprise. This is what happens when a community lifts a team and a team lifts a community. your love, your energy carried this team through this year. I want to thank you, fans. We had some difficult stretches this season, but no matter what the one-loss record was, you came to the park with your orange shirts and your panda hats and your Hunter Pence signs. You didn't boo us when we were down. You didn't quit on us. You had the players' backs during the toughest days of summer. And they returned the favor with a truly brilliant finish and a truly brilliant October. You know, during the postseason, as these guys grinded out win after win after win, there were some people out there that were saying, there's no explaining these Giants. Well, for all those people, here's the explanation. We are an organization and a community that picks each other up. What makes all this work, as corny as it might sound, is a sense of all of us truly being in this together. The fans, the players, the coaches, the front office, the ownership group, every usher and every vendor in the park. There's a culture at the Giants of genuinely caring for one another, loving each other. That's our X factor. I remember hearing from Madison Bumgarner and Buster Posey after one of the rarest things in the postseason, a small blip in a historically spectacular postseason, when there was a throwing error in the NLDS. Buster stepped up and took the blame by saying he had told Madison to throw to third base. Madison took the blame right back from Buster and said, Bum said, don't know about that. He didn't tell me to throw it into left field. I love that. They had each other's backs. It's something you see not just on the field, but you see it throughout our organization. I want to acknowledge the selflessness and camaraderie of all the people at the Giants who, like the players, live this job day in and day out. It's not by happenstance that the Giants have won 3 world championships. It's the product of scouts. It's the product of scouts on the road for some 300 some odd days a year. It's the coaches down in San Jose and Richmond and Augusta preparing young players like Joe Panic for the moment they step onto the field at AT&T Park. It's the product of a general manager who constructs a roster with painstaking care, plucking this pitcher from Boston, that slugger from free agency, that pitcher with a world-class resume. He finds those special players who have the grit and the heart and the talent to be on this squad. Jake Peavy, Tim Hudson, and Michael Morse have been Giants all their lives. It's their inner quality. They just needed Brian Sabian to hand them the uniform. These 3 world championships are also about a manager whose own will and resilience set the tone for this team. That championship blood he so admires in his players, it coursed through his veins first. And when he believes and he goes to battle, the team follows him. Giants fans, your manager is destined to Cooperstown. And of course, this third title is about a group of men who shared a vision in spring training. They saw themselves as world champions, and they didn't care about history or prognosticators or anything but each other. They knew no team in 35 years had won a Game 7 on the road. They didn't care. They scrapped and fought in Kansas City, just like they did in Pittsburgh, just like they did at Washington, and just like they did at St. Louis, until that last ball of a long season descended into Pablo's glove. Tim Flannery nicknamed this group the nitty-gritty dirt band. And the grittiest of them all, of course, is a 25-year-old lefty who in the last 3 weeks established himself as the greatest postseason pitcher in the history of baseball. 4-0 in three World Series championships, an otherworldly .25 ERA. And in Game 7 Wednesday night, Madison Bumgarner emerged from the right field bullpen like a warrior onto the battlefield and notched a 5-inning save after a complete game shutout in Game 5 3 days earlier. Remarkable. Something else, I want to share something else that's remarkable and something without which we would not be here today. And that's the Giants ownership group. They saved the team in 1992. They agreed to take the risk of building a privately financed ballpark in 2000. And they now have supported us through three World Series championships. And I wanted today especially recognize a family that set the stage for these celebrations with their constant love and devotion, and that's the Burns family, who through their heroic leadership, not just saved the team, but carried the team forward to this day with the original guidance of the late Sue and Herman Burns, who we think about often, and now their family members gracefully carry on. Please acknowledge Trina and Rob Dean and Tori and Stephen Humphrey. You met our alumni earlier, and quite frankly, baseball has always been about family to so many of us. The stories and love for the game are passed from generation to generation. I think about the children here today who someday will be telling their children about the 2014 Giants and Madison Bumgarner's thrilling performance, just as we told them about Will Clark and Barry Bonds, and our parents told us about Willie Mays and Willie McCovey. My father passed away 1 week before opening day this season. I missed him every day of the season, and I miss him here today. But I carry his passion in the Giants in me, just as my children and my wife Pam carry it in them. So baseball is the most beautiful of sports because it's continuous in that way. Each new generation of fans are stewards of this great game. No generation has been more committed, more passionate than the fans of the San Francisco Giants today, right here and right now. Thank you so much for all the love you give us. Thank you for celebrating, and let's see you back here next October. Thank you.
Thank you, boss, and congratulations again. And now, fans, to say a few words right now, I want to bring to the podium a brilliant mind, a beautiful baseball mind. He is the longest tenured general manager in all of Major League Baseball since being named to the position on September 30th, 1996. During his 16 years as general manager, he has seen the Giants capture 7 postseason berths, including 5 National League West Division crowns, 4 National League pennants, and 3 World Series championships. Give it up, please, for Senior Vice President and General Manager, the man that puts this team together, Mr. Brian Sabian.
Before we hear the signed Pablo Chan, I think I'm a little light, Larry. Not enough, right, Pablo? Brought that on myself. You know, in the last three runs, each championship and each experience has been so different. The one common theme, which everybody that knows me and knows I hate it so much, is dealing with the press. I don't mean that in a bad way, but it kind of floors me on the one hand and fascinates me on the other hand, how people are always asking why. And if you're around the sport and if you're around our organization, you should already know that. Larry touched upon the continuity in this organization. It's unsurpassed in any organization in all of sports. The commitment of the ownership group, which has been longstanding, the front office, which is so consistent in their commitment to excellence, their loyalty, a front office that's dedicated beyond what the contract reads, what the hours bring. Player development and scouting doesn't start and stop in the minor leagues. It continues through the major league team and 3 or 40 man roster. And our group is as good as any. We probably have more long tenured employees on the baseball side of things than I know of any other organization, and that's amazing to me. Everybody's kicking around the word dynasty, so I'm gonna throw this out here. It doesn't make any difference what anybody else thinks. We're our own dynasty. Within our own organization, with our own city, with this team, this is how they're gonna be remembered. Any other definition doesn't apply. The greatest thing that was accomplished this year was, it wasn't against all odds. It wasn't because we didn't deserve it. It's because these guys have more talent than they think they do. We know they have more talent. And at the end, talent wins out. But their character really showed throughout the playoffs in how they stood tall together and took on any and every opponent, whether it was an 18-inning game in Washington or the seventh game in Kansas City. I'm proud to be a Giant. I hope this isn't the last one I see. It's a tall order in this business to return to these things and return to a podium like this. But God bless the fans. You're the driving force. God bless the city that so embraces everything we're about. And I can't say enough about my feelings today for our whole organization and the appreciation that we feel. Having said that, before I bring up our Hall of Fame manager, just on a personal note, I want to God bless Jim Fregosi, Dom Zimmer, Barney Nugent, and Stan Selesky, who passed away this year. Thank you, folks. Bruce Bochy.
Players of Warriors, your Warriors, are coming out today in this rain. This has been awesome. As many of you know, in 2010, I nicknamed that team the Misfits. And it was a group that came together that got it done. Now, in 2012, our motto was never say die. And of course, this year was yes, yes, yes. And I called them Warriors. This is a team that silenced the crowd in Pittsburgh in their house. And this is a team that beat St. Louis twice in their house. And this is a team, I said twice, I'm sorry, this is a team that beat Washington twice in their house in St. Louis. And this is a team that had to go to Kansas City and win the world championship in their house. This is the best postseason team in this era, there hasn't been a better postseason team here. And this group here, and I want to thank them, and I told them a couple of days ago before the seventh game, what a great honor, what for me, to manage such a tremendous team and a gutsy team like these guys. And they always kept that never say die attitude. You know, they don't care if their backs are to the wall. They don't care if the odds are against them. They come out and they play for you, and they play for each other, and they keep coming at you. And so I want to tell them, in front of all of you now, their fans, I want to tell them thanks for their warrior spirit and the fact that I got to manage this gutsy group. Thank you, guys. And to you fans out there, believe me, never, never question your role in all this. You did help us get through what was a tough year. As Larry mentioned, we had a tough time, but we looked out there and had a sea of orange, and you guys stood behind these guys. You are a force. And these guys, they feed off that force. I feed off that force. So I want to say thanks. Thank you. Thank you for your tremendous support, unwavering support all year. And, you know, for me to manage this group in this city and with all you fans is truly a blessing. I mean that. Thank you very much.
Bigger round of applause for our skipper, Bruce Bochy! Three world championships under his leadership and guidance. Amazing. And now, everyone, I am pleased to introduce to you the best Spanish broadcast team in all of baseball. The voice of the Giants on Spanish radio for the past 15 seasons, Erwin Higueros, and his partner, a forever Giant, who wore the orange and black from 1965 to 1974, Tito Fuentes!
All right. Yes. Three times in 5 years. It's unbelievable, right? If I reflect on the postseason for this year, it was actually torture. For the very first time in my career, I felt very nervous in game 7. And I kept blaming the cold, but it wasn't the cold. But just to be standing up here in front of you guys, all of you fans back over there, I just feel privileged, and I want to say thank you to the whole Giants team. These 25 guys that are making this possible, just make me part of this for the third time. I just want to say thanks. Thanks to everybody, and we can have a round of applause, please. Es increíble estar aquí una vez más, la tercera vez en 5 años. Y en realidad no tengo palabras para expresar la gratitud y lo contento que me siento de estarme dirigiendo a todas las personas que hablan español. Yo creo que están todos allá atrás, ¿no? Oh, también aquí enfrente. Que se escuche. Me siento contento por esta gran oportunidad. Si no fuera por los jugadores, si no fuera por la organización, sin duda alguna no estuviéramos aquí. Así que muchísimas gracias a todos ustedes por darnos la oportunidad de transmitirle los juegos a nuestra estación, la 860 ESPN Deporte Radio, porque nos han, ¿cómo lo pudiera decir? Nos han aguantado Porque en realidad este el trabajo que Tito y yo hacemos es una locura porque es una diversión. ¿O no es cierto, Tito?
Yeah. Muchísimas gracias por todo. O sea, realmente es un placer y un honor que se va a quedar para siempre en nuestros corazones y en nuestra memoria, que en 5 años nada más hemos ganado 3 campeonatos. Y como lo decimos, pero el ser gigante no solamente el uniforme que dice gigante, esto tiene una trayectoria que empezó allá en New York y la trajeron aquí. Tenemos que también siempre recordar que para ser gigante tenemos estas historias que tenemos aquí, que son 5 miembros del Salón de la Fama, los cuales ya ustedes saben quiénes son. Ellos cogieron la bandera, la más dura, porque ellos cuando llegaron aquí en el 58, ellos fueron los primeros que se dieron a conocer aquí para que fueran aceptados. Después nos la pasaron a nosotros y así sucesivamente, y ahora viene el grupo nuevo que lo ha hecho a las mil maravillas. Entonces, ¿qué quiero decirle? En el 10 dijeron que era una cosa increíble que iba a ser. En el 12 dijeron, ah, tuvieron suerte. Y ahora en el 13, lo único que pueden, el 14, ah, me equivoqué. Lo único que pueden decir es que somos grandes porque somos gigantes. Go Giants.
Do you want to say a few words in English?
No, no, not this year.
Oh, not this year. So in 2012 it was only English, and now it's only Spanish. Okay, all right. enough about us. Now please, dos orgullos de Venezuela. Please, let's hear it for our third baseman, Pablo Sandoval, and our center fielder, Gregor Blanco.
Buenas, buenas.
¿Cómo está mi gente? How you guys doing? Increíble, verdad que para mí es un orgullo estar parado de nuevo aquí, al frente de esta orgullosa fanaticada que nos dio la razón y el motivo de pelear cada día más, cada juego, cada inning, mis compañeros, cada segundo ustedes nos dieron la razón de estar aquí para disfrutar cada momento de esta. De verdad que ustedes se merecen esto y mucho, muchas cosas más. Yo estoy sin palabras, de verdad, porque ustedes me han brindado un gran apoyo y me han abierto las puertas de su corazón. De verdad que un orgullo, ustedes se merecen esto. Le dedico todo este triunfo, mi compañero y mi persona, le dedicamos este triunfo a la fanaticada de los Gigantes San Francisco de la comunidad latina. De verdad que ustedes se merecen esto porque ustedes han trabajado fuerte y nos han apoyado a nosotros para nosotros estar aquí. Gracias, muchachos, por todas estas cosas que me brindaron en esta temporada.
¿Dónde están los latinos? Ah, qué bueno, qué bueno. Bueno, ya como todos saben, Pablo lo dijo todo. Pero la verdad que es un privilegio estar aquí hoy en día entre todos ustedes. Yo creo que en mi carrera han pasado muchísimas cosas y para estar hoy aquí significa muchísimo. Muchos de los latinos que estamos aquí hemos pasado mucho en nuestras vidas. Y para estar hoy aquí siendo campeón mundial latino significa mucho. Y esto es para todos ustedes. Se lo dedicamos de todo corazón, todos los latinos y todo el equipo de los Gigantes de San Francisco, que Dios los quiere siempre. Y para arriba los Gigantes.
All right, let's hear it for Pablo Sandoval and Gregor Blanco. All right, we're not done yet. Now I have 2 more players that are going to come over here and talk to you guys. Jeremy Affeld and Javier Lopez. Let's hear it for them.
Good
Gracias, gracias. ¿Cómo están ustedes? I just got a couple people I want to thank. I'm going to keep this short and sweet and keep the party moving. One, sup, San Francisco! Hey, all right. So thank you to you guys. We wouldn't be here without you. I also want to take an opportunity to thank the Kansas City Royals for drafting Jeremy Affeldt and letting us have him. I also would like to thank the other half of the, the other half of the broadcast team. They bring it into the house every night for a lot of you. And I personally want to thank the girl that brings it to you guys in the clubhouse and has participated in quite too many, I think, champagne baths, but it's okay. Amy J! Now, Jeremy Affeldt, please.
Hola. So, right. I know we've been talking about a lot of guys, and we were joking on the plane. We were thinking maybe if we did the ring this year, we wouldn't even put our names on the side of it. We just put Mad Bum on the side of the rings. But because he's getting a lot of credit, and he deserves a lot of credit. But I honestly, in all seriousness, you know, I've been a part of an awesome bullpen. And I know we don't get a lot of credit, so I'm going to go ahead and kind of pump the bullpen a little bit. I personally am really, really proud to be a part of an unbelievable bullpen. All the guys that went out with us this year and competed in the back end have been awesome. I got to play with four guys, Casilla, Romo, Hav, so three. Well, I won't count myself, but four. That I have actually got to be here for three rings and be a part of three rings because of the help of these guys. So I'm very proud of this bullpen. I hope you are too. Now, I got asked a lot of questions in the playoffs this year, and the common question is, what do we need to do to win a ring? We didn't need to do anything. We had to want to do something. We didn't need to win in Pittsburgh. We didn't need to beat the Nationals. We didn't need to beat St. Louis. We didn't need to go beat Kansas City in their house in Game 7. We wanted to beat Pittsburgh. We wanted to beat the Nationals. We wanted to beat St. Louis, and we wanted Game 7. Como wa? I know Como too. And my last thing here, I want to tell you, we're wearing these sweatshirts. You know, when we went into Kansas City both times, we saw the phrase, you know, take the crown. And that's what royalty wears. They wear that. This is a dynasty. So I agree with Mr. Sabian, I really do. I don't care what they say at Dynasty. If you've been on a Major League Baseball field, if you've come to a San Francisco Giants game, we all know how hard it is to win these games. And so I'm proud to stand next to three trophies. I'm proud to stand up here next to all these gentlemen behind me who played their hearts out to win this ring. The front office, our families, our fans, we can all wear a different shirt. And our shirts say what a Dynasty wears. It says, kiss the ring. And that's what we wear, and I'm proud of it.
All right. Now it's my pleasure to introduce the best TV announcers, Krug and Kai. Let's hear it for them.
All right, how's everybody? We, us broadcasters, have the best job that you could ever imagine, and I'll tell you why. We have a fan base that is like no other fan base in this country. And if someone were to say, well, can you explain why they're different? It really is hard to explain. But I realized that the best way to explain it is to go back to Game 7 on Wednesday with one out in the ninth inning. There was a pop-up, and it was hit down the first baseline, and it was caught by a giraffe. And we get that. and so does our fan base. And then the biggest out of the year was a pop-up down the third baseline, and it was caught by a... It was caught by a panda, and you guys get that. And that's why we love you. I'm going to break out the 2012 elimination because it's audience participation. And you guys have been standing around and sitting around, and you want to make some noise, and we're going to do that. And I want you to make some noise. You know how the home run call goes, correct? Barry Bonds is here. I got a chance to call a lot of them. The pitch to Bonds. He hits it high. He hits it deep. And he hits it high. That was awesome. All right, that's pretty good. Remember, it's like a three-part call. It's ah, duh, here. All right? All right. Let's start out with the Dodgers. Yes. They were supposed to go on in postseason, but they did not. The Los Angeles Dodgers, they are... That's not bad. That's not bad. The Giants travel to Pittsburgh. It's just it's an elimination game. Pirates were favored. Guess what? The Pittsburgh Pirates... They are... That's exactly right. They are out of here. Now, the Nationals. On paper, everybody said, oh, Giants don't have a chance. This is going to be a quick series. Well, guess what? The Nationals. They are... Yes, they are. You bet. Now, the Cardinals. This has been a rivalry for quite a long time. Cardinals, well, maybe... A lot of people said they were better, but guess what? The Cardinals, they are... All right, we'll save the best to last. The Royals have home field advantage, and they take it to game 7. And you know what? They're pretty good. They are. But they're not here. We are. The Kansas City Royals, they are... Yes, they are. And here's my partner, Mike Kruko. Thank you.
Thank you, Smoothie. We've been praying for rain and parades for a long time. And we get them on the same day. How cool is that? 1982, I got traded to the San Francisco Giants, and I got a phone call from my roommate that I had with the Phillies, Tug McGraw, who was a Vallejo native. He was raised here in the Bay Area, and he was a diehard Giants fan. And the first thing he said to me was, congratulations, you're going to the land of the believers. And he was right, and that's who we are. You believed in this team since 1958, the first time they strapped it on at Seal Stadium. And this group of players behind me and every other player that ever wore that Giants uniform believed in your belief. It's what fuels us. It's what gives us personality. We sing about it every eighth inning at the ballpark. We even have the guy that wrote the song come out and sing it with us. And what has happened along the way is we have become the center of the baseball world. Nobody has it better than us. But my favorite thing in this postseason was after game 1 in Kansas City, a writer asked Pablo Sandoval, that's a pretty good crowd here tonight, right? And Pablo says, yeah, it is. But we get that every night. And every one of these guys will never take you for granted. You're why they aspire to be great. Your belief, your pride is the backbone of every accomplishment they've ever had. And it allows me to stand here before you again today for the third time in 5 years And I can say, we are the Giants. We are San Francisco. And we are the world champions.
All right, let's take a deep breath. We got a little bit more business to do. And part of that business is to call up a guy that he started his career over on the other side of the bay, and he's found a home here. And he got to pitch two games in the World Series. He is now one of our favorites. We're gonna bring up Tim Hudson. Huddy.
Holy freaking scamoli. Boys, y'all believe we're world champs? Huh? I cannot believe we are world champs. Huh? Actually, I can't believe it. That's why I came here. Sabes, it was about a year ago that that y'all reached out to me in Alabama and got that ball rolling for me to come back here to the Bay Area. You'd have the opportunity to come here to San Francisco. Like I said, for a long time, I came over here as an opponent, and I really admired you fans. I really, just appreciated how y'all brought it every night to the stadium and supported y'all's team. And I'm just so thankful and happy that I was a part of this year. It's funny how things happen. You know, this is how I dreamed this year would unfold. And for it to actually happen, you know, how I envisioned it back a year ago when I signed with San Francisco, you know, it's truly amazing. I'm so thankful for some amazing teammates, guys. I really appreciate y'all. this is an amazing group, and I just thank God that they blessed me. It was one of the best years of my life, definitely the best year of my baseball career, hands down, not even a close second. And it's been a long one. I've waited a long damn time for this. And I thank y'all for being behind us. Thanks for accepting me and my family with open arms. And I can't wait till next year.
Let's go, Giants! Let's go, Giants! Let's go, Giants! Madison Bumgarner and Buster Posey.
Well, before I get started, Ryan Vogelsong asked to come to the mic. Vogie.
Thank you, catcher. Thank you. Anyway, last time I was up here, I brought you on in a little phrase we were using at the end of the year to get us through the tough times. So I'm superstitious, you know, enchiladas, super duper burgers. So I said, Buster, you got to get me up there so I can do it again. So here's what we had this playoffs and through the whole season. So when a cool song would come on in a clubhouse, we had kind of two ways to say this. Tim Hudson's favorite was real quick like this. Oh, sick! And the second one was just real nice and slow and loud. Oh, sick! Huddy liked that, didn't you? So then, this World Series song came out after we beat the Cardinals, and at the end of this song, Robin Williams was in the song. They put his voice in the song. And I don't know if y'all were at Game 5 of the World Series. They played it on the scoreboard when he took the team out in the 2010 playoffs. So I loved what he said. And it was just two words. And it hit all of us, and we felt it. And we felt him with us during this playoffs. And it was as simple as this. Yes, indeed! They Thank y'all. I love y'all. Bogey out.
Well, that was a little weird. We're all a little weird here, though, so it's okay. You know, I'm relieved. I'm relieved that I'm up here and Hunter hasn't come up yet. He's a tough guy to follow. And Hunter, you see those cameras right there? That probably means live TV. So choose your words wisely, pal. You know what, guys? Last year, when the season ended, a few of us came out on the field and we talked to you. And we talked about how we were disappointed with the season last year. And we were going to take that disappointment and use it in the offseason to work, use it in spring training to get better. And the cool thing was is you guys believed us. And we believed that we could get back here. And because of that belief, because of you guys packing out the ballpark every night, bringing your energy, your passion, this is the product. This is the product. It's a third world championship in 5 years, and we can't thank you enough. Thank you.
Thank you, guys. This is the best moment of our lives and our baseball careers. You couldn't ask for anything better than this. And, you know, to be here standing right now on this stage, this is what we all play for. And, you know, it's unbelievable. And in spring training, you know, we had one goal, and that's to win another championship. And here we are with our third one in 5 years. That's pretty amazing. Like they've been saying, this is a dynasty. And there's no way, there's absolutely no way we would be here without you guys. You make it so fun for us to come out and play in front of you every night, and it's been awesome. Thank you so much. I love the signs back there too. Also, that's great.
All right, we got some more business, and this is the inspiration. He is the inspiration, and he had a great postseason. He had a really good year, but he had a great postseason, and he surprised us after the last home game, and he entertained the crowd, and I'm sure he's going to entertain you again right now. Here's one of our favorites, Hunter Pence. Hunter.
I got a microphone. Sweet, sweet. I can't believe they keep giving this to me. First of all, Buster, you thought Vogel's song was weird. Just wait a minute. Before I get started, I would like to get all the players, all the team. We're going to gather around here with the trophies. We're going to get a picture. Don't get too close because I need one guy in particular who promised me something earlier this year. Mr. Tim Hudson, you're not done yet, buddy. Mr. Tim Hudson is one of the greatest leaders in this clubhouse. He's been completely funny. He promised me, we have this really weird warm-up that we have to do every day. It started in spring training, and Hudson was like, what the heck is this? It's called an ankle skip. And we told him, we said, Tim Hudson, when we win the World Series and get on that in City Hall on the platform, you're going to have to ankle skip across here, and he told me he would. Tim Hudson, give us a little ankle skip. Demonstration right here, boys, ankle skip. Woo! And one more thing, drop a War Eagle on him.
War Eagle, baby.
Roll Tide. I don't know what that means, but he says it to us a lot, so we had to drop it on you. So, standing here right now is quite the dream. I talked to you about a month ago about vision, and a lot of you joined with me, so I don't think we'd be standing here if it wasn't for your collective vision. I gotta thank all of you for sharing the dream and making this a reality. It's pretty special. Let's get weird. I think you all remember a little bit of the yes, yes, yes. Do y'all remember that? All right, I'm just gonna say whatever comes to my mind, And I want everyone to give three yeses with me as I raise my hand. First and foremost, Madison Bumgarner.
Yes, yes, yes.
Buster Posey.
Yes, yes, yes.
World champions.
Yes, yes, yes.
Can we do it again?
Yes, yes, yes.
That's what I'm talking about, San Francisco. Hold on. We're gonna come back to that. We're gonna come back to that. I just wanna have a little more fun. I wanna have a little more fun. Actually, wait, one more. Jeremy Affeldt, Scudderball. When I say Frisco, you say Giants. Frisco.
Giants.
Frisco.
Giants.
Man, why do they give me the microphone? I'll keep going. Re-sign Pablo.
Yes, yes, yes.
We need about five more for that. Re-sign Pablo.
Yes, 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 yes.
Hold on. Santiago Casilla. Real quick, real quick. This was my man right here. This is one of the truest, one of the biggest warriors I've ever been a part of. He inspires me every day. He stood up day one, actually game one, a World Series, and told all of us that he had a dream. And he asked us all to share the dream that we would win the World Series and this team was blessed by God. So glory to God, baby.
Yes, yes, yes.
Thank you, Casilla. Let me see who else we got here. Brandon Crawford's curly hair. San Francisco City Hall, we love you, baby.
Yes, yes, yes.
And that's about it. I think it's time to get a picture. Guys, this has been the best year of our lives. I gotta say this as well. I gotta give a little bit of a message. We didn't do all this hard work. We didn't put our hearts, our souls, bleed, taking everything and anything to win this thing if you guys didn't enjoy it. So it makes us feel good for you guys to have as much fun as you possibly can. Get rowdy, have fun tonight and enjoy it. We're all thankful for you guys. Let's do it. Michael Morse. And I think y'all remember, saddle the heck up, boys. We're burning it down, and that's metaphorically speaking. So paint the town red, San Francisco, you're the best.
With your 2014 three-time world champion, San Francisco Giants! Photo op time! And stay right where you are, everybody. We have one special moment coming up to wrap up our celebration. Stay right where you are. special musical treat coming up, everybody. All right, once again, everybody, thanks for coming out for the parade and this city celebration. Now we're gonna celebrate with some music. Please welcome from the Bay Area's own Train, lead singer Pat Monahan.
Used to love the tenderloin till I made some tender corn. Then I met some ladies from Marin. We took the highway to the one up the coast to catch some sun. They left me with these blisters on. Don't know what I was on, but I think it grows in Oregon. So I kept on going, going on right through. I drove into Seattle rain, fell in love, then missed a train. Could have took me right back home to you. I've been high. Sounds so bad. At least they'd have a hell of a fine Merlot. Oh, if I could wish upon a star, I would hitch a cable car to the place that I could always call my own. I've been high, I've been low, I've been yes, and I've been rock and roll and disco. Won't you say?
This next one, but I would like to invite the whole team and the whole city to join in as a congratulatory song by a band called Queen. I've paid my dues time after time. I've done my sentence, committed no crime and bad mistakes. I've made A good friend of ours from San Francisco is going to come up and sing this next verse. Matt Nathanson.
Taking my bow, my curtain call. You brought me fame and fortune and everything that goes with it. I thank you all. But it's been no bed of roses. Consider it a challenge for the whole human race. We are the champions, my friend. And we'll keep on fighting to the end. We are the champions.
Hey, thanks so much, everybody. Congratulations.